Horizontal asymptote at y equals 0. These guys have a vertical asymptote at what? Their embraces of each other, so all the y's are x's and all the x's become y's. So this is a log base 10 graph. When you type it into your calculator, can everyone type this in? Log base 10 of x. Type it into your y equals and look at it. If you go to draw it, most of you will stop here. Your log graph always looks like it stops. It doesn't. It just gets so so infinitesimally close to the y-axis that it looks like it's it can't draw because it looks it's gonna try and touch it, right? And you know it can't touch there. So when you see this, please don't fall to it. It keeps going. It just runs really close to along this axis. It will always run down. You see that? Don't make it stop. Okay? All right. So, this is the graph. It's running along here. Oops. I forgot to make it thinner. Then there's 2 log 10 to the x. Still runs along here. And then we have 5 log 10 to the x. So it runs along here. Arrows down here. There still is, and you should draw, when you draw these, you should always draw the dashed line on the y-axis because you have a vertical asymptote there. So we'll do the first one. What's the x-intercept of the first one? Something in 0. 1 and 0. What's the y-intercept of the first one? What's the y-intercept of this one? There isn't one. What's the domain? X such that x is greater than 0, because they just switch the logs and exponentials, right? So exponentials, it's y is greater than 0. Logs, it's x is greater than 0, because they're inverses. And the range? It's y such that yer, because there's no y's that don't exist on here. And if exponential is xer, log is yer. This one has a vertical asymptote. X equals 0. What's the end behavior of this graph? What we could just say is it's on the right of the y-axis if we want to say it. End behavior is usually down on left. This one would be down on left, up on right, technically. And if this is a test, you'd have to write down on left, up on right, not arrows, correct? Because it's notes. You fill in the other two. The x-intercept of this one is 1, 0. X-intercept of this one, 1, 0. Do you notice a pattern with all of these? Everything has been the same consistently so far, right? That's me being lazy. Don't do that on a test ever. They'll be like, oh gosh. All right. So let's go through these ones. So here it says, which function matches which graph below? What is ln x? What is that just the same as? Log base. What was the base? It's base e. Ln is just log base e. E is just like pi. It's a non-repeating, non-terminating decimal. And I'll show you how to get it. So, just so you know what it looks like or where to find it, instead of pressing pi, because we're not doing pi this time, if we wanted to do E, E is found behind the lawn button. So if you went second E to the 1, that's what E represents. 2.718218821, blah, blah, blah. Okay? Like pi is 3.14159. E is that. That's all it is. So you don't have to worry about it unless you have to convert. Then you'd have to put the E down, right, to convert to an exponential. So 5 base 2 to the x and 2 base 0.1 to the x. What is 1 and what is what? I have an A and then I have a 1. Okay. What is 1 and 2? What kind of graphs are these? 1 and 2, what kind of graphs are they? Exponential. They're exponential graphs. So this tells me it's a what? What is that? Y-intercept at 0, 5. And what does this tell me? What does the 2 tell me? Increasing. So which graph is exponential? Exponential also has a horizontal asymptote, and it either does this or this, right? It's above the x-axis. So which one of these would represent A, B, C, or D? B. Now this one is an exponential as well. The 2 is the y-intercept at 0, 2. And what does the 0.1 tell me? Decreasing. So which one? D. So it's at 2 and it's decreasing. Now, this is a log x, 6 log x and negative 2 log x. This is the key thing to note. When it's a positive 6 in front, your log is increasing. When you have a negative in front, your log is decreasing. So log functions, remember, log functions have an asymptote on the y-axis, and they either increase, run along it and go like this, or they decrease, run along it and go like that, right? So if 3 is the increasing one, which one would it match, A or C? Remember, you read from your graphs from left to right. So which one of those, if I was drawing them, would be increasing? C would be. They start low and then go high, right? This one would match C. And then this one would match A because it's decreasing, starting high and going low. That's it for that. Okay. So those are the exponential and log questions to review. On Monday, we're just reviewing through all that and polynomials. It's going to be super fast. Bring your A games. So if you review this on your own, that'll help. Tuesday's your test. Yeah.